For better or worse, this movie kept throwing me curveballs, and I'm still trying to process everything and understand what in the world I just watched. Let's go. Before we kick off this review, my name is Chris, and thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it if you hit that like button, and if you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. This way you'll stay up to date with more fun reviews uploaded weekly. So Brahmastra Part 1 Shiva is the opening chapter in India's first original cinematic universe known as the Astroverse. I did not go looking for this movie, I didn't even know it existed, but I pay the AMC monthly membership and I have to see around 2 to 3 movies once a month to get my money's worth. And this movie just looked like a good time. I found this new movie on the AMC app and this is what got me intrigued. So bear with me as I describe the plot of this movie, because if I just do it myself, I'm probably going to confuse you way more. And you tell me this doesn't sound awesome. Inspired by deeply rooted concepts and tales from India's ancient history yet set in the modern world, Brahmastra Part 1 Shiva is an epic story of fantasy, adventure, love, and hope, told using cutting-edge technology and a never-before-seen visual spectacle. The grand adventure features a stellar ensemble cast of some of India's most beloved actors. Set in modern-day India, the narrative is woven around the existence of Astras of power that have been protected by the group called the Brahmash. The most powerful of these Astras, named after the most powerful weapon of the gods, is the Brahmastra. A mysterious dark force is trying to wake the Brahmastra, threatening the universe we know today. The new film sees hero Shiva journey into this magical world of Astras, where he learns of his mysterious connection to the Brahmastra. Shiva discovers the truth both about his own destiny as a divine hero, and about the great power that dwells within him, the power of fire. Okay, so yeah, I got a little lost too. You know, they keep saying bra this, bra that, and you know, as American audiences, we say bra all the time too, but it's more of like, you know, meeting your friend, meeting your boy. You know, bro, you good? You okay? You good? And then we keep it moving. But they combine that word so much throughout this whole movie that at times I kept thinking of Martin, because you know there's only one and only bra man.
Bra man, no, you did not eat all the Thanksgiving dinner, man. Everything was hidden too.
Or even that episode of South Park with Cartman.
Please welcome Cartman Bra.
But pretty much this is an action-adventure film at heart with a romantic buildup between the two main characters. The Astra of Powers gives off abilities that resemble animals, such as if I had the power, I could either be as fast as a monkey or as strong as a bull. And these concepts are definitely cool and interesting. The Brahmash is a secret group throughout history that holds this power, and it's kind of similar to the Marvel Avengers. Now there's an evil group of characters that are trying to capture this power so that they could take it back to their leader, or he appeared to me as like an emperor or something, and he's known as the Brahmastra, hence the title of this movie. Now I could have misinterpreted that synopsis, so my apologies to all the hardcore fans, people of India, Bollywood lovers, but for now let's get into my pros and cons of this movie. So check it out, this is why I said this movie is insane. As you're watching the first 20 minutes of this movie of how they explain everything, just like how I told you guys, out of nowhere, and I mean out of nowhere, and this is what threw me off, because now that I look back on it, I don't think I've ever watched a Bollywood film before. Unless you count Slumdog Millionaires, but I'm not quite sure about that. But this movie right here went from 0 to 60 with a massive dance number. This performance was huge. They had hundreds, I think maybe even 1,000 background dancers all jamming and dancing with the main protagonist. The massive wide shots really paid off because I actually felt like you were there with them. From the fashion to the colors to the amazing set designs and how they transitioned from a day to night sequence, this musical part of the movie was just awesome. I was immediately entertained by the main actor and really excited to see where they take this character. You also start to feel empathy for this main character once you hear his backstory and where he's from. I thought the movie had good pacing, especially when it came to the main character and how they were peeling back those layers throughout the film. And for the most part, the acting was pretty good, although you can see for some of the actors it probably wasn't their best work. But I did think the chemistry between the male and female lead were believable and you were rooting for them throughout the movie. There were some scenes where the graphics and visual effects were outstanding. Maybe not for some viewers, but for me, this is the reason why I wanted to see this movie, because my local theater was actually shown in IMAX 3D. As they were fighting and throwing objects, the 3D was really beneficial. I mean, at times I felt like I had to dodge a few bullets. I thought the story was decent, but the Indian mythology was very interesting. And the songs were good, but some of the musical sequences caught me off guard. I thought with Bollywood, usually these movies have one large musical number, but midway through this movie, the male and female characters were in this boat, right? But then out of nowhere, the guy comes from up behind her and just starts singing out of nowhere to her face. So if this is her face, my man, like, as the camera, right? Like, we just see her. My man, like, does one of these and, like, sings right to her face all slow and... I said, sing your heart out, bruh. Do what you gotta do. Now for the bad part. But unfortunately, this movie online, it looks like it's not doing so well with the critics. And rightfully so. The sound design felt strange. There was many times throughout the movie where the musical score was so loud that it didn't really match the scene being shown to us. And it just felt super loud and unnecessary at times. Don't get me wrong, the score had great potential. It was decent music. However, I felt like they also overused the theme of the music. You know those thematic moments. Usually there's a particular character in a movie, and every time their presence is shown on screen, there's usually a type of music that goes with that character specifically. If anyone happened to watch this movie, then you probably know what I'm talking about, because when it comes to the main female character, every time she was on scene or there was that romantic interest, they played the same music over and over and over. As an American watching this film, I did feel the beginning and ending were very rushed. The beginning felt rushed because it was difficult trying to read the subtitles while also watching the screen to follow along. I said subtitles, and you heard me correct. This entire movie is spoken in Hindi with English subtitles, at least for me where my film was, and I did not understand a single word. Well, maybe a few words. There was a few random words throughout. But I didn't mind watching a movie like this in theaters because it was a new experience for me. I was able to follow along and get used to it definitely by the midway point. This movie is so damn long, especially for a part one. I think this is a trilogy with a part two and three coming out years later. But when you have a movie that's 2 hours and 45 minutes, it gets to the point by the end of the movie, you're asking yourself like, okay, are we done now? No. Are we done now? I said before that I did think this movie had decent pacing because it is an adventure story. But by the end, they just threw all the answers at you. And maybe that's the setup for part two that's gonna come out. Some of the writing felt way too simple and immature at times, such as using standard phrases over and over, whether if it's just saying, I love you all the time, or even the female character. There were so many times where she was screaming out for the main character's name, Shiva. Like, Shiva, Shiva, Shiva. Come on, bro. The last negative I'll talk about is related to the fight choreography, because there's this one scene where I just have to mention. We have our protagonist, and he's trying to save his girl, and he needs to jump off this ledge to get to the bottom floor. Now, the shot is behind him, so we see him running. We're, like, almost with him as he's running. But we also see the target that he's trying to reach down below on the bottom floor. Now, when you see him, and, like, where he's about to take off, and, like, where he's trying to reach, ain't no way he could jump that far. You see it, like, and there's no way he could reach that. Only Michael Jordan could jump that far. That's it. That's pretty much it. Now, once he jumps, there's an edit of him in the air once he takes off. So you see that edit, but then out of nowhere, there's like another edit from a different angle where he reaches his target. It was kind of strange to see. It's like, all right, here we go. And then he just makes it. I'm like, okay. We're just gonna let that pass. I'm just gonna let that go. I mean, I know how gravity works. I mean, he's not no Michael Jordan, but maybe he's a Brahmastra, you know? But that's for you to watch and find out. Or never watch and find out. I don't know if this is going to be on streaming or whatever, but, you know, and I don't even know if I'll watch part two. Overall, I was able to follow the story, and by the end of the movie, you really grasp the meaning of what's going on. You're rooting for the hero of the film. The villains appeared intimidating, although not frightening. The subtitles for English viewers were very helpful, especially what they put in parentheses what something meant in Hindi. This is only part one, and like I said before, I might not even watch part two. This should have been a TV series for Netflix or something. I think the promotion and build-up would have been better for American audiences. Y'all already heard my pros and cons, so with that being said, I thought this movie surprisingly was just okay. It was chill.
Nothing, just chilling.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button. And if you want to see more, just subscribe. If you want notifications for new uploads, hit that bell icon. Also, if you could share this video with your family and friends, I would greatly appreciate it. As always, now and forever, thank you again for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace.